Canadian fans. Tonight, Vidori Ito tries to regain a world championship lost last year in Halifax. Also, the free dance finals. Defending champions Klimova and Ponomarenko stand third. Sandwiched between the two Soviets, the Duchennes. Is it their year to break through? And the leaders, as we head into Dance Wars 91, Yusova and Zulin.
The following is a CBC Sports special presentation. The 1991 World Figure Skating Championships from Munich, Germany. Brought to you by Ford of Canada, where quality is more than a commitment. Quality is job one. Buy your local bottler of Diet Coke, just for the taste of it. By the Dairy Bureau of Canada, which offers you butter. And by Petro-Canada, dealers and agents across Canada. Committed to Canadians. Now at the Munich Olympic Halle, here is your host, Brian Williams.
It is a busy night here on the grounds of the 1972 Summer Olympics. Bayern Munich is playing a big soccer game in the outdoor stadium. Here in the Olympia Halle, a capacity crowd as the World Championships continue. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to day five of CBC's continuing coverage of the 1991 World Championships. Tonight, medals will be awarded in the dance competition. Isabel and Paul Duchesne, the Canadians, now skating, of course, for France, stand second heading into the free dance program. They are bracketed by two couples from the Soviet Union. Now, in addition to the dance, the other big story is the women's singles begins tonight. The question is, can the Japanese sensation Midori Ito regain the world championship she won 2 years ago in Paris but lost last year in Halifax? It's a big night in Munich. And right now, let's go down to the ice level. Here is Chris Cuthbert. Chris?
Brian, the ladies' event at the 91 Worlds is the most wide open of all of the competitions. The defending champion, Jill Trenary, isn't here because of ankle problems. Midori Ito is the 89 champion. She's here, but her status somewhat uncertain because of jaw surgery in January. And there are so many contenders.
Well, I think today will be very interesting. Now that the ladies no longer have to worry about school figures, I think we're going to see two very different categories in the ladies. We'll see the jumpers, Midori Ito and Tanya Harding. We'll also see the more stylish, well-rounded ladies like Nancy Kerrigan and Christy Yamaguchi.
And we'll also see two Canadians, Paul.
Chris, the Canadian team is riding high on the crest of a wave. We're hoping to stay on top of that wave today with strong performances from our new Canadian champion, Josée Chouinard, and former Canadian champion, Lisa Sargent. Both of these girls have practiced well this week, and we're looking for big things for them in today's original program.
We're looking forward to the competition, and we begin with the newly crowned American champion, Tanya Harding. 37 skaters are entered in the women's original program, and we begin with the new American champion, who has become somewhat of a sensation since winning the title in Minneapolis a couple of weeks ago. This is Tanya Harding.
Tanya's picked an excellent year to make her first world team, as this is the first year there are no compulsory figures, at which she was not very proficient, but she is an outstanding free skater.
Thank you.
performance like that, I don't think skating early is going to hurt her marks at all.
Well, Paul, she just ignited this arena here this afternoon, and I think that this one is going to be up there amongst the leaders.
Somewhat of a surprising American champion, but she said, I can't be overwhelmed with what happened in Minneapolis. I have to try and accomplish it again.
Here's a look at that triple lutz.
Oh, my girl.
Look at the height on that jump. Perfect landing and straight up into the double.
The first set by 7-8 for Tanya Harding.
I think that's a set of marks is definitely going to place her in the top five here.
Well, one of the questions was, could she handle the pressure being in the spotlight? She certainly has answered that question quickly. The artistic marks include a couple of 5-9s. Tanya Harding will be among the leaders. She's the first legitimate contender to skate today. Former Canadian champion Lisa Sargent is warming up. She's next when CBC returns to the 91 Worlds in Munich. Canadian ladies champion Lisa Sargent of the Royal Glenora Club in Edmonton. Lisa's second in Canada this year, sixth in the world's last year, and she's hoping to improve on that.
Well, I think she also knows that here at Worlds it's a different story. She was sixth at last year's Worlds. She's been seen by the judges, so she just has to go for broke here.
This is going to be an interesting set of marks because she has attempted the combination twice in the short program, and as I understand the rules, you are not allowed to reattempt any one of the elements in the program.
That was a very unfortunate mistake because Lisa, for me, is a very all-around solid skater. She has really nice jumps. The music matched the costume. She has a great package. And I think if she had completed all of the elements, she would have seen some nice marks.
Michael Juranek, coach of Lisa Sargent, and the world champion Kurt Browning, anxiously awaiting those marks as well.
Here's a look at that combination. The second time she tried it. Here's the triple toe loop into the double toe loop. It's actually a different combination than she attempted first. She tried a double flip And the double flip seemed to be fine. She had nice height. And then it looks like she just didn't get a grip of her toe pick to get the spring into the air.
I think we could see a little bit of time taken here on these marks because the judges have got to decide whether or not they have to mark the first combination or whether they can take the second one into account.
So plenty of suspense here as Michael Juranek and Lisa Sargent await the marks. And she has paid a price down to a 4-6 from the German judge. Just 3 in the 5 for Lisa Sargent for technical merit. Sixth in Halifax last year, and that's why there are two Canadians here this year. The second set of marks are much higher.
Well, the fact alone that she tried the combination for a second time shows me she's a really gutsy skater, and I think we're going to see that in the long program.
Still to come, the French and European champion, Saria Bonnelly, when we return to Munich.
Glockenspiel in downtown Munich. It's in the church steeple located at the Marienplatz. That is the downtown square in the center of the city. The music plays and the figures spin twice daily, 11 in the morning and 5 in the afternoon. Well, you just saw the figure spinning on the Glockenspiel. Of course, we are seeing combination spins tonight in the women's original program. And right now, with more on combination spins, here is one of Canada's top international figure skating judges, Jean Sent.
Without the compulsory figures, the portion of the singles event that will set the initial stage is the original program. Here, the skaters will perform 8 required elements consisting of jumps, spins, and footwork sequences. We're going to focus in on one of these elements for you to give you something to identify and to try to judge for yourself as you watch these programs. It's the combination spin. First, the spin must have at least 2 changes of position, meaning 3 different positions, changing twice between them. The skater will revolve in no particular order through a camel or parallel position, a sitting position, and a form of upright spin. In addition to this, the skater must change feet once, but only once. This can be done at any time during the spin, either as a small jump or a hop, or a simple step over. Lastly, a minimum of 5 revolutions must be performed on each foot. Here is a spin for you to evaluate. Count the rotations as we watch. The first position is a camel position. Notice the parallel body line. This is followed by a layback, which is a form of the upright spin. Here's the change of foot, followed by a sit spin with a true sitting position. Once you've captured all that, try to assess if the skater rotates in one spot or travels away from it. A good spin should be centered. Watch the rotations. Are they stronger or faster on one foot or the other? We look for a balanced spin. And lastly, how pleasing and how original are the 3 positions chosen? That's a lot to look for, and this is only one of 8 required elements, but give it a try.
Saria Bonnelly of France was 9th at last year's World Championships, but she is clearly a contender here. The 1990 World Junior Champion, the 1991 European Champion.
Saria will be one of the few top ladies about to attempt the very difficult combination triple lutz double toe. She does it.
watched this skate as a program. I felt that she improved so much artistically. There are still moments, however, when it suddenly disappears for seconds. During transitions from, say, one element to the next, she appears to lack in it, but it has been something that she's obviously been working on and has improved.
I think coming from France, everybody's just waiting for her in Albertville, that's for sure.
One thing she doesn't have to worry about improving is her figures now that they are no longer part of the competition. She was 15th after the compulsory figures in Halifax. We talked about the quads throughout last night's program. She has two different quads.
Well, after watching her jumping performance here in the short program, it'll be interesting to see if she does try and execute both of them in the long, because she looks very confident out here today.
Here's a look at that triple X combination. You can see the height she gets on that jump. And no faltering whatsoever, straight up into the second jump. And you can see her coach in the background jump up. She's very excited.
Didier Gagoué is the coach, and he led the cheers throughout the European Championships, and what a year for her. Every competition she enters, she has won. It will be very interesting to see how the judges place her in relation with Tanya Harding, who had a sensational program to open things up. Here are the first set of marks for Saria Bonnelly of France. 5-5 from the Finnish judge, up to 5-8 from the Dutch judge. So she is going to be right up there alongside Tanya Harding. Let's wait for the artistic marks. For Saria, they haven't been as high, and they are not. 5-4s up to 5-7s and a 5-8 again. So Saria Bonnelly is now in second behind Tanya Harding, another great jumper and former world champ. Welcome back to Munich, and here is the 1989 world champion silver medalist last year from Japan, Midori Ito, who had a rather anxious moment in the warm-up, a collision with Letitia Hubert of France. And Midori was on the ice for about 30 seconds. How unsettling will that be?
I'm sure it's very unsettling for her. It looked as though she was injured. She went on to do a single Lutz after that and then hit the boards on the second attempt of the triple Lutz in warm-up. She is attempting the triple Lutz double toe loop combination. She does have a very determined look on her face. Let's see what happens.
She jumped so close to the board, she's gone right out the camera chute in the corner.
Oh, that's exactly what happened in the warm-up, only she didn't go through the board. I can't believe that.
This is a European-sized ice rink. This rink is 100 feet wide, and I can't believe that she ran out of space.
Well, Paul, as she was going into that jump, she had more speed than I've ever seen her have going into that jump, and I was thinking that was going to happen going in. Down after this.
think we've seen another first here. I don't think I can ever recall somebody going out the camera chute. And although she's smiling and she's looking herself in the head, she can't believe she did that. She technically has only missed one element, but I'm sure that the camera chute is going to be up for much discussion after that event.
Well, Paul, the fact that there, I don't think that would have happened had there been boards there. I think she could have pushed herself off and she would have been fine. But the question is, did she land the jump before she went through the chute?
Still, she gets a standing ovation here. And she's coming over to check out, see if the cameraman's all right.
Definitely a first here today. She's picking up the pieces of the board.
Oh, the fans love her. 1989 champion Midori Ito, again concerned about what kind of shape she was in after the jaw surgery, but I talked to members of the Japanese delegation just a few minutes ago. They said she skated perfectly yesterday, and they really expected her to do well.
Jump. Beautiful triple lutz. Look how close she is there to the board. Takes off. And right on the landing of the jump, she hit the board.
Here it is on another angle. Probably the cameraman who almost got hit. She goes up. Nice tight position in the air, executes the triple lutz, goes to jump the double toe, and I mean, she's going to land right on the cameraman.
She actually had a smile on her face as she made the first jump. Unbelievable. And here are the marks. And what a range. Some judges didn't penalize her at all. A 5'8 from the Bulgarian judge, 5'2 from the Austrian judge.
Well, Chris, I don't understand the 5'8 because although her landing foot did hit the ice, I can't see how one could consider that combination as a successfully landed combination.
All right. Here are the artistic marks, and they are more consistent and they're higher. So Midori Ito will stay in contention despite that problem. She's in second place behind Tanya Harding of the United States. Let's take another look at it. The first jump landed beautifully, but Midori runs out of ice, and she really crashes down hard. Like she landed on her hip, and look how quickly she got back into her program. Really almost didn't miss a beat, and it's just a wonder that she was able to skate so cleanly the rest of the way. Well, she has the skate off, and she's being helped. There's Brian Williams. Let's go down to join Brian to get more on the Midori Ito situation.
She doesn't know yet how bad exactly.
Is it the ankle or is it from the puncture in the skate?
It's from the puncture. It punctured through the skate and through the tape.
Is her foot bleeding?
We'll see how bad it is,
probably.
This happened when she went over the board. Did she hurt her hip too?
Her hips are worse than this.
You're her coach, man?
Yes.
All right. Thank you very much. Thank you. Is the ankle swollen? They say you were soaking it in ice. Is there a danger of perhaps a sprain or a fracture of the ankle?
Don't think there's any injury to the ankle.
So again, in your estimation, all things being equal, she could skate again tomorrow?
I do hope so.
Thank you. What did she say anything to you? Is she in pain or anything?
Yeah, she's feeling some pain, but she wants to skate tomorrow if possible.
And she is in the hospital now?
She's in the hospital now.
Will she be x-rayed there?
Yep.
All right, Chris, the doctor's saying there is no cut to the ankle. Now, remember, Midori Ito already had an ankle injury, so there was a tensor bandage around the ankle. Thus, when the skate was sliced open, there was no laceration to the ankle. She is very fortunate in that respect. And again, the injury did not occur when she fell during her program through the boards. It occurred when she had a collision during the warm-up. Again, Ito is in the hospital. They do expect her to skate tomorrow. We'll update it later in the program. Stay with us. Up next, Canadian champion Josie Chouinard when we return to Munich.
Well, Chris, she had an excellent warm-up. She's had a chance to get her act together backstage as she skates at the end of this flight. Let's see what she does here today.
Looking very determined.
Looks pretty cool for her first world championship.
Nashville next year.
Well, being the first time that this is for the judges to see Jose, I'm sure they're going to be very impressed with this performance. Every jump was very solid. Her expression was great. The smile was delightful. Great to watch.
A top 10 finish is her goal here. She's a little concerned about the recognition factor coming in because these judges haven't seen her before, but she's made an impression, I think.
Well, she certainly made an impression on me. I saw her at a divisional championship just over a year ago, and she was certainly a disappointment. Skated poorly, and I cannot believe how much she has learned since then in terms of performance.
It's to her advantage that the ladies' event started last. She was telling me she was feeling a little poorly earlier in the week and then said maybe it was just too much German food.
Well, I think we have to take into account that the current success of the Canadian team can't help but be inspiring to these girls.
Here's a look at that beautiful combination. She gets great height on it. Very solid landing. And straight back up. And it's perfect. You can see by the smile on her face.
The first singles champion of Canada, hailing from the province of Quebec. So Charlene Wong was very influential on her career, and I know she skates professionally now. Long wait for these marks. Joanne Barbeau is the coach of Jose Chouinard. Did not win even a provincial title until she was 18 years of age.
When you know she's nervous, she tends to really stiffen up on those landings. There was no sign of that today. She had very nice knees. She was just on.
And we continue to wait.
There's some discussion over behind the referee's desk, and I don't know if it's not. Here we go now.
And there are the marks for Chouinard, 5-3 from the Yugoslavian judge, up to a couple of 5-6s for technical merit.
Those are a really nice set of marks for Jose's first world.
Impression of 5-8 from the Austrian, who has her ranked second, but what a spread down to a 5-2.
That 5-8 brought Jose jumping right out of that seat in the kiss and cry area.
So a terrific performance by Jose Chouinard of Laval, Quebec. She stands seventh. When we return to Munich, a close-up look at
Christy Yamaguchi, a 19-year-old from Northern California, moved 2,000 miles from home to a new country, new friends, and a new outlook on life.
I think the move up to Edmonton has definitely worked in a positive way for me. It was a bit of adjustment last year, but I feel this year I'm a little more settled, and the training atmosphere is just great, motivation, and I feel really lucky to have been able to train up here.
She has a new lease on her figure skating life, living in Edmonton with coach Christine Ness and husband Andy.
In the 2 years she's been up here, I think she's gotten a lot more independent. She's grown up a lot. You know, she's not a child anymore, and so it isn't like I'm having to parent her. It's just, we hope, you know, Andrew and I hope we're giving her a nice place to live.
It's not easy for a youngster to move away from both home and family.
There are times when I miss my family. But, you know, I'm up here for a reason, that's to train, and, you know, I know that's just a sacrifice I'll have to make.
Christy had to make another sacrifice. World Junior Pairs Champion with Rudy Galindo, she also skated with Rudy in Halifax. However, after the death of her pairs coach last year, she decided to concentrate on singles and with coach Christine Ness moved to Edmonton.
We never really set definite, you know, limitations to ourselves and or to Christy or what she can do. We try to have, you know, she really wants to make the U.S. Olympic team. That's really important to her, and I think that's a definite possibility. I think she has an excellent chance of a medal, and what color it'll be, I don't know.
That's an 8.5.
And Christy has had absolutely no problem at all fitting in Edmonton.
Since I've been up here in Canada, I've, you know, changed a little bit. I think my attitude towards skating is a little different. I try to go out there now with a more positive and stronger attitude, whereas before, you know, I wasn't really quite sure what was going to happen and what I really wanted. someone who's really inspired me a lot is Kurt Browning, and just training with him and seeing how he goes out there to compete and his attitude has really helped me. And I went through a rough period last year, and just seeing how he handled things, you know, I learned some things from him, and I think it's really been helpful. All the skaters at the Glenora do get along so well, and you know, we help each other out on the ice and push each other, but off the ice we're also pretty good friends, and you know, it's fun to go out with them, and everyone's just really friendly, and there's not that competitive feeling you feel at other rinks.
Contender to skate today was Tanya Harding, and she is in first place. The last contender to skate, another American, Christy Yamaguchi, who finished second to Harding at the American Nationals.
Now, Christy's planned combination is also the triple X double toe in the same corner as Midori.
An outstanding example of how nice a spin could be in the original program.
Christy really combines all elements of this program, the spinning, the jumping, and everything in between.
Yet another strong performance turned in by an American girl. All three of the American ladies have done an outstanding job here this afternoon, and I think with that performance, we're going to see all three of them in the top 10.
Most of the fans here at the Olympia Halle are on their feet for Christy Yamaguchi of the United States. She lost that close battle with Tanya Harding, and it appears the battle's on again.
You saw the way she clenched her fist there. She was really pleased with that performance.
Well, Christy isn't exactly a spectacular skater, but she's a perfect skater, and she's beautiful.
That was Michael Slipchuk, another teammate from the Royal Glenora, and there's Christy Kasgard-Ness, her coach. She followed her coach up to Alberta. And this is her second year skating out of Canada for the United States.
Here's a look at that triple combination, triple left, beautiful height, and straight into the second jump, no problem.
Here are the first set of marks. They may be the best we've seen today, starting with the 5-7, up to a couple of 5-9s for Christy Yamaguchi.
Well, Chris, depending upon her artistic impression with that set of marks, we could very well see her in first place.
And there they are, the reaction from
in fourth place, and a strong showing for Jose Chouinard. She's in eighth place after the short program.
Thank you.
Championships, you did a great performance. Were you nervous?
Yes, I was nervous, but I think it's the way I performed the best, and I like it.
All right, you like to go out there being nervous. Were you watching Midori Itō when she fell?
Yes, I was. I felt sorry for her, but I think she went back on the ice and she did her stuff. That's good.
All right, it's rare that you get to see other skaters before you go out. You're not always out. Did that bother you a bit that she was possibly hurt?
Usually I don't watch the other skater before me, but now I just went out there and did my job. So I didn't really matter. It didn't really matter me if I was watching the others because I wasn't going out there and I have a place in my mind, so I was only doing my job. So it was okay. I didn't mind.
It was okay indeed. She did her job here tonight in Munich. We'll see her tomorrow night when the ladies program wraps up. But right now, Chris, let's go back up to you.
Well, it was almost as if the women were determined not to be upstaged by last night's outstanding men's long program, but Midori Itō didn't have to jump over the boards to get our attention. Barb, your thoughts on the competition?
Well, it was certainly dramatic. It was also controversial with Midori Itō missing an element and still sitting in third position. As well, the big story here, three Americans in the top five. That's incredible.
Paul, what about the Canadians?
Well, Chris, the story in the Canadians is one of disappointment and exhilaration. Lisa Sargent skated early in the performance, did not skate well, and now finds herself in 18th position going into the long. Jose Chouinard, on the other hand, was absolutely brilliant. She put in a wonderful show and finds herself sitting in 7th going into tomorrow's long program.
All right, later we will have an update on Midori Itō's condition, but coming up next, we'll have what's become a CBC tradition, Kurt Browning analyzing another world championship performance. That's when we return to Munich and more of the 1990s.
And on this Friday night, welcome back to the Olympia Halle in Munich, Germany. Still to come, the free dance portion. Of course, the Canadians skating for France, Isabel and Paul Deschaney. Now, earlier today, Kurt Browning dropped by the broadcast booth to go over last night's championship program. This is becoming somewhat of a Canadian tradition. I remember back to Paris, the Omni Sport in 1989. You won on a Thursday night. Friday, you came in. You went over the program. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I do remember that. It was a lot of fun. Yeah.
Now, that was the first time you'd seen it, wasn't it?
That was the first time I'd seen that program, and I think this will be the first time I've seen this program, too. I'm more nervous now than I think I was then.
All right, Kurt has not seen the program. Let's roll the videotape. Take us through it last night. How nervous are you at this point?
You may not believe it, but you're concentrating so hard and you've been looking forward to this moment so much that you're really not nervous. What you want so badly is to hear the first note of the music. And this moment right here sounds like it's forever.
You always pull your sleeves.
Especially the white sleeves. They always hook onto my wrists. Just makes me feel a little bit more comfortable. Small little things to make you as comfortable as you can be out there. The first few moves of the program, I never want a trip. Even a small trip, because you can waste a lot of adrenaline by getting scared or spooked. So we're warming up for the triple axel, triple toe loop. You sure want to start the program off with a bang. Not too smooth on the end. And actually right there, I felt a lot of excitement for two reasons. One, I was proud of myself for pulling that off. And two, a little bit of confidence was lost with the shaky landing of the toe. And I think that's what caused this to happen. As far as I'm concerned, right now, I'm still doing four revolutions. It's right there that I open up for three.
Now, what do you think? You decided to only do three. What goes through your mind now? Your coach said he was wondering what was going on.
Right now, I'm disappointed because all season, especially this week, I've been nailing that quad. And one of the things that I really wanted to do this week was to show everybody that the quad is still part of my repertoire and that I didn't, you know, leave it at home. But right now what I'm doing is talking myself out of it. Those are negative thoughts. And you've got no time out there for negative thought. Right now all I'm seeing is a sea of red and Canadians cheering me on. So I've already probably forgotten about the quad toe.
That's interesting. You mentioned the Canadians. When you go this close to the boards, do you actually make any eye contact with anyone, or do you just wipe it out?
Sometimes when you slow right down, you might pick one person out, and if you can make eye contact with one person, then you're simultaneously making eye contact with everyone who's sitting around that person, and it works very well.
Now, people that don't skate, I don't think they realize just how physical this is. When do you start?
start to get tired because you had those sensational combinations?
Actually, right now I'm still doing pretty good. I'm running on the first little bit of energy that a person has when they start a physical routine. Right here I had a bit of a... You can see there's a bit of a indecision right there.
Yeah.
And I changed that move during the week, and it probably wasn't a smart thing to do. But this part felt good. I remember my coach's words to push, get lots of speed before, so you don't have to push on the last jump. And nice and smooth. Good.
Were you aware of the fact that this had to be perfect? I mean, is that going through your mind, too? You didn't do the quad. You have to be 110% from here on in?
Yes, it's true. As I'm going into these last few jumps, I know I've already made one mistake, and I always allow myself in my head to make one mistake. This really made me happy. All season long I've been having trouble with that combination. Not in practice, but in competition itself. So right now I'm in that spin celebrating, just going, oh, this is going well, this is the way it should be, the spin feels good, let's have a little bit of fun with this music now.
You say you want to have fun. Is there a point when you say to yourself, hey, I've nailed this now?
Not really, because like you said, I wasn't allowed to make any more mistakes. I knew the competition behind me was really tough, and on the other hand, I can't show that I'm nervous or concentrating too hard. I've still got a program to do. Right about on this next couple of hops is when I start thinking about the three triple-triple combos. No one in the world had ever done it, and I certainly didn't want it to be the first. Let's go for it. That's exactly what I thought of going into that.
Right on indeed. It was almost like you gave a high five.
Yeah. Right here is where I look up and see the Canadian team. Hi, guys.
Do you actually think that hi, guys? Do you remember seeing anyone in particular?
Yeah, I could see Tuffy and the whole team, everyone wearing red and taupe and looking pretty sharp. And they're all cheering me on, and everyone had a big smile, so I knew that it must have been going pretty well.
In no other sport does an athlete stand out there almost naked, no teammates. How do you handle that pressure?
Well, hopefully you absorb it and enjoy it, because right now you've got, you know, 12 or 13,000 people or how many just watching you, waiting to see what you can do. It's your opportunity to shine. And right now I'm just going, this was pretty good. I have absolutely no idea how I'm going to place. All I know is that I came here, skated pretty good, and I am done.
You were done indeed. There are the fans. Now, for sure, you had to see them at this point.
Yeah, I bowed to the other side on purpose first so I could sort of catch my thoughts, and then I said hi to the Canadians. And look at them. They're having a great time. They made such a difference. Really and truly, it was like being in Halifax over again. Paris was the same way. Canadian skating fans are certainly, there they are, certainly some of the most incredible people I've ever come across.
As we come back on camera, let me ask you, at this point, did you want to watch Petrenko skate? You did, but
well,
I mean,
of course. Yeah. Really and truly, I'm a skating fan like anyone else, and I want to see what everyone else is going to do. If I didn't have to skate, I would certainly be front row watching. And watching Victor skate, I mean, it's both of our futures, and I certainly want to see what's going to happen.
You said to me last night it felt like a two-minute program. I said to your coach, you got a few extra gray hairs. He said that was no two-minute program, but you felt strong.
I felt really strong, and more than physically, I'm impressed with... I'm impressed with coming back after the mistake, and it was a personal victory for myself.
It was a personal victory. It was a great victory. I know I speak for Canadian fans. They're looking forward to Albertville. Where do you go from here?
I go on tour, and I won't be coming home to Canada until about March 31st when we do a McDonald's Stars on Ice in Toronto. And that's going to be great because I think that maybe all of Canada can celebrate with me when I get home.
I think they were celebrating last night. Listen, you were the Lou Marsh winner as Athlete of the Year last year. You took a big step towards repeating this year. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Kurt Browning, a tradition I hope we carry on in Albertville.
Now we'll sure try.
Thank you, Brian. When we return to Munich, the dancers take center stage as the 1991 World Figure Skating Championships continues after this.